Microsoft mostly gets detections right. Infrequently, however, you might encounter email, URLs, or file detections that you'd like us to examine a bit more. Submit those to us. We'll analyze them, make determinations, and correct the detections, if doing so is appropriate. For example, you might submit an undetected email that you believe is malicious, a false negative, and we'll analyze, confirm, and add a detection for it. On the other hand, a false positive may be an entity you believe we detected by mistake. You can submit that too. And if our analysis confirms it, we can resolve the issue. In either case, we'll provide you detailed information about our determination. So feel free to submit samples that you're just unsure about to get our take on them. If you have Microsoft Defender for Office 365, the easiest way to submit an email sample is right in Explorer. After using Explorer to investigate this email, I've determined that it's not actually malicious, a false positive. Without leaving the page, you can select an email and choose one of the submission actions available: report clean, report phishing, report malware, or report spam. In this case, I believe the email is clean. You can also submit email for analysis right on the submissions page. At the top of the page, select Submit to Microsoft for analysis. Then, you can submit an email by using its network message ID or uploading an email file, a URL, or a file. Track all your submissions on the submissions page. Near the top, you can specify a date range, filter by submission type and submission ID, and sender, submitter, delivery reason, and status. The table lists each submission matching your criteria. Aside from the obvious details, like an email sender and subject line, the list shows the submission type and status of each item. That status will be pending until we finish analyzing the item. Then, it changes to completed. Going from pending to completed can take from several minutes to a day. If we found a policy override or email authentication problem, it takes several minutes. If the submission requires feedback from a grader, it takes more time. Of course, you can select a submission status to see more information about it in the details side pane. This includes the results, including feedback from graders, submission, and other details. For emails specifically, that includes information about policies or failures that might have impacted or overridden the verdict. A person's safe senders list or exchange mail flow might have allowed delivery, or a failure in the sender's email authentication might have prevented it. So far, I've talked about admin submissions, items that you submit in Microsoft 365 Defender for analysis. You can also review user submissions. How this works depends on how you configure the user submissions policy. You can enable the report message feature in Outlook, and then choose whether those go directly to Microsoft, to a custom mailbox, or a combination of both. If you've configured a custom mailbox to receive user-reported messages without sending them directly to Microsoft, you can review and submit those on the User-Reported Messages tab. For all intents and purposes, this changes a user submission to an admin submission. To do that in the list of user submissions, select an email and choose one of the now familiar options: report clean, report phishing, report malware, or report spam. In Microsoft 365 Defender, you can quickly submit email, URL, and file samples to gain clarity on whether they're malicious or not, and to correct false positives and negatives in our detections. For more information about submitting samples, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs.